positions, please?
Absolutely. Charlie Maurer, head baseball coach, Baron Carter High School. Johnny Long, junior catcher. Connor Phelan, sophomore third baseman. And Nick Denovi, senior pitcher.
Can we get an opening statement about today's game?
Yeah, I mean, went up against a heck of an arm. And anytime you do that, we preached all week, you got to play mistake-free baseball. Came out of the box hot like we wanted to early on against him. Thought we had a bunch of success. Get his pitch count up and actually swinging the bat fairly well off of him. But against a good team at this level, especially with an arm like that, you can't kick balls like we did early and give them opportunities. For a while there, we kept the pressure on them for three or four innings every inning. We had guys in scoring position, and we just couldn't catch a break. You know, it was second and third in a big situation early on, first and second, two outs. We just couldn't finish it off. Like I said, against an arm like that, you just can't. You have to capitalize on every mistake they make, and they didn't make any, and we did.
Questions?
Johnny, you had those two errors early in the field, the team did, and I think they scored a couple runs off of them, took the lead. How tough is that in a game like this where there's already a bunch of pressure to see, you know, the team make effort, and does that affect you going forward?
It doesn't affect me at all going forward, but pretty much it's frustrating having that, having those two plays that really kind of cost us a little bit, but we've been in situations in these type of games where we knew where we could come back, and we were down a couple runs, and we never really gave up, but we really couldn't find the bats at the end.
Any other questions?
Nick, like Coach said, you kind of struggled, especially at the top of the order against their pitcher. What did you see from him? I mean, as a pitcher yourself, how good was he and compared to what you faced this year?
I mean, he was good. He was exactly what we thought he was going to be. I'm a little frustrated, say, with my at-bats where I took pitches that I didn't think were strikes, but they got called strikes, so.
Yeah, there was an at-bat in the second where it's like you took a couple steps towards first, like you thought it was ball four. Did it feel like there were some kind of dicey pitches there?
Yeah, that, and it was a really late call. He didn't say it till I was already out of the box, and then he started to play. That's just how it goes.
He is Charlie, though. That was kind of a big moment, that second, the punch out on the fourth. I noticed you sort of let the blue know your opinion on that one.
But, you know, it's. I don't want to overshadow what they did and what their arm did. It's a part of the game, you know. Calls for you, calls against you. That goes both ways. But my frustration was because you're facing a potential first round draft pick, and when you get someone on the ropes like that, you can't let them off easy. You know, I felt like the zone was consistent up to that point. We were just starting to get comfortable with it, and then the heat was on. But you know what? That's an excuse. We should have capitalized earlier in the count. It's by no means, I don't blame games on umpires. But yes, it was a very pivotal moment there where we get a knock there and blow the game open, and it's a momentum changer, you know, and maybe he comes out early and maybe we score four or five runs. And there was another situation early in the game where I thought Nick had the guy punched out. We were up 1-0, we runners on second and third, I think it was, and it was a fastball in, and we really liked the pitch, and the next pitch, of course, is a base hit. You know, that's the game of baseball, and sometimes it goes your way, and we've been playing on the edge of our seats for the last couple weeks now with momentum baseball. So when you get those opportunities early, you got to strike.
Coach, how proud of your players this year? A very tough schedule, and the way that they play this entire season. How proud are you?
I couldn't be prouder. I mean, this group, I've said it a million times. It's, if you had asked me in March if we would have been here, I'd have told you you're crazy. And it's a testament to these guys. I'll go to war with these guys any day, you know, and I preached it the last couple weeks, is culture wins, rosters don't. Today we fell short, but by no means did we not belong on the same field as that team. And that's a testament to them competing. You know, we're still young. We only graduated a couple starters. But as far as proud, I couldn't be any more proud. You know, they competed even in that game, as it got bloody there at the end, they just didn't stop. And that's how they've been all postseason, all years. They don't stop. They could have laid down in March when things weren't going our way because of the way the schedule was. We just kept getting pounded and we couldn't get healthy, and there was a lot of adversity, and but they had it in their brain to keep fighting, and that's what got them to this point.
Nick and Connor, going up against their pitcher, I'll start with Nick. Do you feel that pressure when you see if he's on his game, you know, where you got kind of have to match him, so to speak? And does that wear on you as the game goes on? And then Connor, you had the big hit there in the, I think it was the fifth inning, double down the right field line. Just take us through that sequence where you guys were able to get back in the game, and do you feel like you guys had it, you know, had the chance there over those last three innings?
Yeah, I think we had a chance in those last few innings, but then they scored more runs. And
How tough was that? Was that good to face, though? Taking me through that bad if you could, too. Obviously, field up.
Well, I thought he was going to be throwing a lot harder than he did, and first pitch is inside, and I took it the other way.
And do you mean when I was pitching or hitting?
Yeah, no, pitching. You know, Do you feel like you have to kind of match him inning for inning?
Definitely. You got to, with an arm that good, you have to try and keep it as close as you can. But they got a couple of timely hits when they needed to get him, and he kept his off balance pretty well. So.
Any other questions?
I saw you nod your head. He was talking about didn't throw as hard as you thought. What were you expecting to see versus what you actually saw?
Well, we've been watching countless videos on him, and most of the times he'd start off the game in the upper 90s, and we'd watch him warm up, and we're just thinking to ourselves, this is a 95. This isn't really as hard as we were expecting. So I'm sure when Nick, when Marcus, when I, when DJ, Aiden, all of us got up in the bat, we weren't surprised by how hard it was. To be honest, I kind of thought it was like a above average high school pitcher arm that we saw today. And I'm sure Aiden said his arm was hurting. He was telling his coach at first base that his arm was killing him. So that might be a reason why, but I really don't think today he really had his stuff. And I think it was just wasn't that as hard as we're going to see.
Johnny, can you just talk about where this program has come and what we can expect? You know, it's two regional championships in 3 years. Got a lot of people coming back, yourself included. So, you know, what can we expect next year and more of this?
Well, most of our teams that we bring up we always bring up the low guys of freshmen, and we do that so they can experience games like this. And honestly, I think next year we're going to be back here because teams like us, we just fight through things. We fight through adversity. We fight through games that are like we're not supposed to win. And that's the culture that is breeded at Barron Collier. And it's a mentality that we have in our heads that we're not going to be average. We're not going to lose. We're going to fight through everything. We're going to put the ball in play. And next year, we're going to have Aiden. We're going to have Sean. We're going to have CP pitch or Connor Phelan pitching. And honestly, we're going to have some freshmen who are probably going to come up, and they're probably going to contribute to the team bringing us back here, just like Van did last game with him pinch running for DJ. He's a freshman, and he ran for DJ because DJ, he's not the fastest, but he got us that run. So the freshmen and the underclassmen are going to bring us up back here.
Just one more. Coach, if I could just piggyback on that. I think third time this is that Barron's been to state semis since winning the state title in 97.
Yeah, I came once as a player and then now two as a coach. Maybe it's me. I can't finish it. My brother and my dad got the title in 97, but I can't seem to get over the hump. No, I don't like, out of respect for Nick, to look past this year right now, but I couldn't be happier with how we're set up. Not only next year, but for the future. Like I said, we only lose a couple of starters. Are they big? Can you replace a guy like Nick Denovi? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. It's that one's tough. So, and the rest of the seniors as well. You know, we preach that pack mentality where everyone's got a role, and it's easy to sit back and see Nick Denovi and go, man, he's hard to replace. But it's hard to replace all of them. You know, everybody buys into a role, and you got to find new roles next year. But as far as roster goes, which, like I said earlier, rosters don't mean anything, I couldn't be happier with how we're set up next year and in the future. You know, I think we've built something special here, and the program has made a huge turn to the good. It's always been a powerhouse program in Collier County, but we're trying to get it to the point where we're here every year, and that's the expectation. and eventually we'll get one. But, yeah, we lose a couple starters, and the young guys that we have coming up are truly special that you guys haven't been able to see yet. And to piggyback what Johnny said, we try to bring them up at the end of the year once the JV season's over. I mean, there's a lot of guys on that roster that would play, start on varsity teams all across the state, you know, but we choose to keep them down to get reps, and then at the end, they bring them up and on the trips to expose them of what's to come, you know, and that's why we do the schedule. You know, it's so funny. I laugh every year we do this. You face these teams that are 25-3, 28-2. I look at their schedule and I just giggle, you know, and we could go do that. That's easy to do. You know, we could stay in town and we could take a couple little trips, but number one, it's not fun, but number two, it doesn't get you better. And the biggest thing to me is it doesn't get these guys to play college baseball. And if you look at program success, it's one thing to get these guys into college to play baseball, but if you look as a track record, the success that these guys have had in college baseball. And I think that's a testament to the program, it's a testament to the culture, it's a testament to the schedule. You know, they see arms all the time. So when they do go, they jump right in. So as far as the future is very bright.